Foz here. I figured what better way after that first video of mine that I did to get over my fear and embarrassment of doing videos than to just make another one right away. And still don't know what I'm doing. I'm hand-holding my DSLR camera here. I have a tripod somewhere. I'll have to figure out where I want to do these in the future, but yeah, just playing it as she goes, one step at a time, I guess. With Valentine's around the corner, I thought maybe I can talk about some of my favorite songs that are on some of the albums that I have. I have lots of favorite, you know, Valentine's Day type songs, love songs, wishy-washy songs, whatever you want to call them, that I used to play in my teens to get me over those lonely Valentines. But I don't have them all on vinyl, so I'm going to just focus on maybe my top three picks that I actually have on vinyl that make good Valentine's Day lovey-dovey songs. So I'll head over to my albums and we'll take a look. Okay, I'm not 100% sure how I want to do this, so I'm just going to show off three records that have three songs on them that mean a lot to me, that had a lot of meaning in my teenage years, and I'll just very briefly explain why they had that meaning, and maybe even play a little sample of each song or something. So, first one, I'm just going to move my camera around. Again, no tripod, no idea what I'm doing. So I'm going to start off with Phil first. My lens makes a bunch of noises when I focus, so I'll have to see if I can get something different. So this is my second favorite Phil Collins album. It was very important to me in my teenage years, in high school. I listened to it a lot. 1989 is when it was made, so obviously I was listening to it on CD at the time, I believe. The song that I have a lot of nostalgia with as far as a Valentine's Day type song is Do You Remember? And this was a song that would be in the there's my cat. Hi, kitty. Do You Remember is one of those songs that I would like to listen to feel sorry for myself. You know, I'm thinking about my ex and I wanted to listen to some lyrics. I can't get a focus on that. I'll read, you know, the lyrics. We never talked about it, but I hear the blame was mine. I'd call you up to say I'm sorry, but I wouldn't want to waste your time. You know, the typical feeling sad sack type story. But really good song. Phil Collins just has a way of bringing out emotions in me. Lots of his songs, you know, all different types as far as, you know, like feeling this one where I'm, you know, feeling sorry for yourself, or there's other happy songs. He's got some nice upbeat love songs. There's the inner jacket, some pictures. I'm sorry, I can't get a good focus on these things. Every time I try, it just makes sounds. What you doing, kitty? This is Woodstove. Hey, Woodstove. So yeah, this album, it's neat, you know, like since I started collecting records, I've been picking up all the albums that I used to listen to when I was younger, in my teens and stuff. Never had vinyl when I was growing up. I just missed that era. You know, I always say I was born in the wrong decade. I was born in the 70s, but I grew up in the 80s, obviously. I was born in 75, so I wasn't going to any Rush concerts or Led Zeppelin or any of those cool guys. I did get this. I have seen Rush 3 times, and I've seen some great, you know, classic rock groups, Van Halen. But I never got to see them in their prime. So that's my feeling sorry for myself song. Phil Collins, Do You Remember? My next song is by Bryan Adams off his Reckless album. And if you know this album, you might be guessing what song it is. It is Heaven. Great song. I'm trying to remove all these albums with one hand, rather hard. You know, the hardest part about making these videos is talking to myself. I am not a wordy person, and I definitely don't talk to myself. So there's Heaven. Oh, thinking about our younger years, there was only you and me. You were young and wild and free. Now nothing can take you away from me. We've been down that road before, but that's over now. You keep me coming back for more. Awesome. Awesome lyrics. It reminds me of my wife so much. We've known each other since we were like kids, but you know, we dated in our teens and fell apart, had our reasons and stuff, came back together. So while I was listening to Phil Collins' Do You Remember, thinking about my then ex-girlfriend, I would also then listen to Heaven. Where is it? Where are you, Heaven? I lost you. Oh, there we are. I would also listen to Heaven and think about my wife as well when things were going good. And yeah, great tune. I'll play you a clip. Bryan Adams, Reckless. There's that. Hey, get away. I don't know if anyone else that collects records has pets, but this cat loves the smell of my old records. I bought a lot off Kijiji a while back, and the crazy cat just went nuts, just sniffing all my records. Probably, you know, years and years and years worth of different pets and different smells and a whole bunch of stuff on these, especially some of the albums from the 70s. Who know what kind of smells are on these records? And my third pick is a song that I still listen to, actually, just, I think, last year or the year before for our anniversary. I did a little slideshow of me and my wife, you know, through the years, and it was put to this song because this song is definitely, all three of these songs, I guess, are reminding me of my wife, but this is by Queen. Oh, wrong side. This is Queen, Night at the Opera. There it is. And the song is My Best Friend. You're My Best Friend. And here's the inside. I gotta do something definitely about focusing and stuff like that. Because, yeah, I'm very sorry. Here's the guys from Queen. Freddie, Bryan, Roger, and John. This whole album is awesome. Oh, that was tricky. So, Night at the Opera. Did I have the right song? No, I'm on the wrong side. Definitely not handling these right. Night of the Opera, My Best Friend. I'm gonna set that there. I don't know if I got lyrics in here or not. The lyrics for My Best Friend are, oh yeah, and, they're on the inside. So not quite as poetic as maybe Bryan Adams or Phil Collins and that, but you know, ooh, you make me live, whatever this world can give to me, it's you, you're all I see. Ooh, you make me live now, honey. Ooh, you make me live. You're my best friend that I ever had. I've been with you such a long time, you're my sunshine, and I want you to know that my feelings are true. I really love you. You're my best friend. And I sing that to Michelle a lot, my wife. Not to a Deacon, as it says there at the front, if I could ever get a focus on that. You know, Freddie had his own folks he wanted to sing the songs to, but I'll just change a word here and there, or a name. And yeah, so it turns out that my top three songs are all reminding me of my wife, And you know what? I'm okay with that because that's why I married her. So I guess I can dedicate this YouTube video to my wife. Let's put my camera back around here. Try to get a focus. So it turned out to be a nice little Valentine's Day tribute to my wife, and I'm okay with that. So happy anniversary, Michelle. I love you very much, and I hope everyone that's watching this has some great songs that they can listen to that either reminds them of their current loves or perhaps loves that they've lost or that are long gone now but can still relive that nostalgia. Hopefully good memories. I know Valentine's Day is obviously very hard on some folks, and I've had those days myself, so I totally understand. But yeah, so that's it. Those were my three favorite songs on albums that I own that remind me of, you know, Valentine's Day, love, and apparently my wife. So I'll say bye, and maybe I'll play a few clips from these songs. Take care.
Thinking about all your years, it was all.